Namaste, this is Mekhala here from poojas.in and I have with me Shalini ji. So she's here again with a wonderful question on all your behalf. Let's hear it from her.
Yeah, Jai Mata Mekhala.
Jai Mata.
In the course of all your the poojas that you get done,
right?
I believe there are two kinds of poojas.
Yeah.
One is the poojas which are done according to the Vedic tradition,
right?
Which are called as the Vedic poojas.
Yeah.
And another is called as the Tantric poojas. Can you please differentiate what is it, how is it different from each other?
Yeah, actually we do two, like you said, we do two kinds of poojas. One is the Vedic, the other one is Tantric. So Vedic is basically what is prescribed as per the Vedas. So where it's not written by a human being, but these are all composed, it's apaurusheya we say. So Maharshis have listened to it through their own clairaudience and then they have made a note of it. So they have not changed and they can never be changed and they are like dictums. So what happens is when we chant those Vedic hymns and perform havans, we are invoking those kind of cosmic vibrations. So a lot of negativity in the house, in our state, in our life gets negated with those. So they have stood the test of time and they will continue to also. So that is the kind of because see, there are very many Vedic experts, they may also expand on each of the mantras also. But what I want to say is the Vedic hymns are used to perform yajnas, homas, abhishekas and rituals. So that is when we call it a Vedic puja. Now what happens in a Tantric puja is, yes, we do Tantric pujas, but we don't get into things like the Vamachar or the black magic and things like that. We don't do that. But there's one more aspect to Tantra, which is the Shri Vidya. So anything related to Shri Vidya, Upasana, Rudrayamala Tantra, you know, these are the pujas which we do. So yeah, if you ask me which is faster, I have from my own personal experience of getting pujas done to different people, a few of my clients, I can say that 7 out of 10 have experienced results faster in a Tantric puja. Like Lord Shankaracharya also practiced Tantra through Shri Vidya. Now that is something that we do where there is no side effects, there is no invocation of karma. At the same time you're invoking grace. This also generates vibrations. It's not that it doesn't generate vibrations, it does. Everything works through vibrations only. But in this what happens is the results are faster simply because it's a combination of bijaksharas and it's a shortcut method, I can say. So you know, you start, it's not like elaborate verses are there, but there are certain things like you have to offer this nivedya, you have to draw this particular diagram, a yantra, and then there's mantra bhaga to it. So we you know, practice mantra and you have to have attained siddhi in those mantras for any tantric puja, because the person who performs it should be a master and adept in it. And how does he become an adept? Through attaining siddhi. Like, you know, there are certain sankhyas for each mantra. You have to perform japa, not praying for anybody, not even for yourself. Just sit and do that mantra japa, follow the rituals, then you gain mastery over it. Then when you go and do the puja, you can do it for others. So all our priests who have done it, they are actually people who have attained siddhis in these tantric remedies. So what happens is they know these mantras and they have you know, attracted the energies of the devata of the mantra. So that's how they have gained the power. And then when they do it, what happens is they get people get results faster. Whereas Vedokta mantras also you get good results, and you get results but not as fast as tantric. But you know, there are certain things for which you need to do only Vedic, and for certain things you only Tantric is what we recommend. Like the Mahamrityunjaya mantra is the supreme mantra, that's a Vedokta mantra. There is no question about whether, you know, if somebody is bedridden, what is the kind of mantra you want him to do. We won't suggest a Tantric remedy, we will say Vedokta remedy. Because he is bedridden, you get a 1,25,000 jap of Mahamrityunjaya mantra done. So then automatically we have seen phenomenal results. So we cannot compare, but there are two different aspects. It's actually comparing apple to orange. It each has its own power. But for certain ailments, certain problems, we will always recommend a Tantric remedy. Especially if you have a Shatrupada and you know, you're facing a lot of problems, a Tantric remedy will yield faster results.
Any examples you can give for Tantric puja that you conduct?
We do a tantric puja called Saubhagya Panchadashi, Swayamvara Parvati. These are all based on Sri Vidya Upasana. And Upasak will know what mantras we chant. In fact, in our YouTube channel also, you can see a whole lot of videos on that. So that is completely tantric. So where we are doing these havans for people who want to get married, who aspire to get married, to find their life partner. Breaking all shackles of their doshas and navagraha, the chart and, we say, no, 27 nakshatras and then navagraha, the kundli, everything you can break. Break the shackles with these tantric remedies. So that is one of the examples. Bagalamukhi puja, it's where Mata Bagalamukhi is the supreme goddess. She is one of the Dashamaha Vidyas. So she is a tantric goddess. So we invoke her for Shatrubada. We invoke her also for good health. Like somebody who's fallen sick because somebody has cast an evil eye or jealousy, we would recommend a Bagalamukhi puja for them. You know, then you get instant protection and you can start seeing changes, improvement in health and financial position, and a lot of these things we can see instantly. Husband and wife relationships have been improving, and especially after they've done a Bagalamukhi. So if the one of the spouses is very argumentative and there's no harmony in the family, so then also we recommend a Bagalamukhi. So it's one of the highest and the most frequently performed tantric pujas at poojas.in, because we have experts in Bagalamukhi puja. So you want to eliminate bad company of your children, they have friends who are influencing them in a wrong way, all those things, we immediately, even if somebody is inflicted by black magic or such evil influences, we do tantric puja. So we do tantric remedies like Bagalamukhi to eliminate that. Likewise, we have a tantric Lakshmi's puja also. So many pujas where we invoke the grace of Kamala, she's Kamala Dharani, so basically the Kamala aspect of her is more prominent in a tantric Lakshmi. So we invoke her through the tantric mantras. Here the mantra is different, the tantra is different, the yantra is different, the nevedya is different, the way the puja is performed is different. Yeah.
If I want to get any puja done, so do I leave the choice to you as to which is the best puja to be done? Be a Vedic one or should it be a tantric one?
Yeah, I think it's better to do it that way. Depending on the intensity of the problem, I would
recommend. You would recommend which one to be
done? Yeah, there is no thumb rule like this. We take it case to case. Depending on the intensity of the problem, we recommend the solutions.
So my job is now only to place my problem to you, and you will do the needful, whichever is required.
That's true, because we are going to consult our experts, in-house experts, okay. And they are the ones who tell us that, this is the problem, this is the intensity. We will look at your chart also, okay. Where we'll also listen to what you're saying as your problem. And we want to also see how urgent it is to solve your problem. And then accordingly, we give remedies. Okay. So it could be tantric, it could be Vedokta, it can be a combination.
Okay.
Only if it's not a conflicting. For example, we would not ever do a Narasimha Swami puja with the Bagalamukhi, because both are Ugra Devatas. But our approach usually is to make sure that there are no two conflicting gods, because gods as such don't have conflicts, but their energies are very different. So we don't want a clash of energy. So we take care of that aspect. So like you said, you just have to state your problem. Depending on the intensity of the problem, we will look into what kind of solution suits you the best. Also have to keep the budget in mind. So that is one more aspect.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for watching this video. So if you have any questions and you want to ask, if you want to know how to approach us or how to approach your own problems, please feel free to contact me. The contact details are just after this video, and we will surely get back to you. Actually, this question was asked 2 months back, I think, if I'm not mistaken. Since that we could not shoot or we did not have time to make this video. So, but we'll be back, and I think henceforth every week we will be uploading one video. So, any questions, please feel free to ask. Thank you so much. Namaste.